Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at how to identify a strong base in organic chemistry. So in organic chemistry, we don't use KB tables. We use trends to predict basicity and base strength. So there's only a handful of strong bases in organic chemistry, and those tend to be molecules that have a particular atom that is small and has a localized charge on it. So we can generically say that a negatively charged carbon, a negatively charged nitrogen atom, and a negatively charged oxygen atom would all be considered a strong base in organic chemistry. And in this case, R, the generic R group, is going to be equal to a carbon or a hydrogen. So those could be as simple as a CH3, like a methide, or they could have other groups on them that are carbon-based as well. So there's a bunch of different iterations of it, but what is the same in all cases is the presence of this negatively charged carbon, this negatively charged nitrogen, and this negatively charged oxygen. And that charge must be localized on that atom, so there's no dispersion of that charge via resonance. All of these bases would be considered strong bases in organic chemistry, and probably what you would see the most frequently is an oxide derivative. These are strong enough bases for most chemical reactions. Now, if we think about relative basicity, here's our little portion of the periodic table here. We know that electronegativity increases up and across the periodic table, so fluorine is the most electronegative atom, and they're getting more electronegative as they get towards fluorine. So in this series, this Cr3- derivative is going to be a very, very strong base. Carbon is less electronegative than oxygen and nitrogen, and so it's going to be more destabilized by that negative charge. It does not have a high affinity for electrons, and so because it's less stable, it's more reactive. So we can think in terms of stability, reactivity, and strength of base. If something is less stable, it's going to be more reactive, and so it would be a stronger base. So for those reactions where you have a need for a very strong base, you're trying to pluck off a proton that's not acidic at all, you would use a Cr3- minus type derivative. Now in practice, carbon is very unstable with that negative charge, and so practically speaking, that molecule is going to be an organometallic compound where you have a carbon that is attached to a metal. So the carbon has the electron density on it, but the metal is there sort of stabilizing that negatively charged carbon because it is so unstable with a negative charge. So this is your series of strong bases in organic chemistry. The oxide derivative, OR minus, is going to be strong enough for most things. The strongest of this series is the carbon with a negative charge on it. I've drawn here N-butyl lithium, which is a common, very strong base that's used when you need to pluck off a proton that is not acidic at all. The carbon has the electron density on it, and when it behaves as a base, that lithium will dissociate into solution just as a spectator ion. So these series of bases are small atoms. They're in that second row across, and they have a localized charge, no resonance structure. They're sp3 hybridized, and that charge resides just on those small atoms. If you like this video and you found it helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends, and I'll see you next time.